Good morning, children and other family members. Today I'm here with you for the children's story. So for our children's story today, we're doing David and Goliath. Now, David is a small shepherd's boy who works on his family's farm with his brothers and his dad. Now, Goliath is a big giant who's very, very tall, probably taller than the church, and he is going to war for his people, with his people. So now David is the youngest out of all of his brothers, which means he was the smallest as well. So David one day, whilst he was in the fields with the sheep and his brothers, they got a messenger coming from the town saying that they needed extra men. So David, being the youngest, was told that he needed to stay with the sheep so that someone could at least stay with the sheep, as his father and his brothers went to the town. Now days went by, and David was asked to bring them some food. So David brought them some food and saw what the sight was. There was a bunch of people that were just hiding. All the Philistines couldn't bear to try and stand up and fight to Goliath because Goliath was so big and huge. They were afraid that they just kept hiding no matter what. Now, David decided that he was going to go talk to the king. When he went to go talk to the king, he asked if he could join the fight. But David, of course, being his age and his height and how big he was, they said he couldn't fight. Now, David was upset, so he started heading back home. But an idea came into his head whenever he passed a stream. He saw many, many stones inside of the stream, and he decided that he was going to take some for himself and go back to the camp. So when he got back to the camp, Goliath was doing one of his normal rants where he was yelling at all the Philistines and intimidating them. Now, David had an idea where he could use his hat as a slingshot. So David took off his hat, put a rock inside, and went into the battlefield. Nobody else was on the battlefield except for Goliath and his people. And for the Philistines, David was the only one who was out there. Goliath started mocking David because of his height and his weight and the fact that he was just small. He was the smallest that Goliath had ever seen. Now Goliath believed that he had already won, because he didn't think that the Philistines were actually going to come out. And he knew if David was the one person that they were going to send out, that they had already lost. Now David had one thing on his side that Goliath didn't. David had God on his side. What he did was put the rock in his slingshot earlier and carried it behind him. Now when it was time to start fighting, Goliath started charging towards him and making big stomps and making it look like he was ready to attack. Before Goliath could do anything, David started swinging his hat back and forth all the way around, spinning it around faster and faster and faster. Now after David was done swinging it as fast as he could, he let go of the rock that was inside. That rock flew all the way to Goliath and hit him straight on the forehead. That one single pebble knocked him all the way out. Goliath was down. Now, Goliath's people were so shocked and so frightened that Goliath had been taken down that they all fled and ran because they knew that that was their only strength. Once their strength got knocked out, they knew they didn't have a chance. After they fled, all the Philistines came out to greet David. David was the local hero. He had made everyone proud that day. Now the moral of this story is, no matter how small or how tall or how big you are, God always has a plan for whatever you're doing in life, and he can help you to do anything that you want to do. Thank you.